iOS 18 has a brand new control center, and we developers can actually create our own control widgets using WidgetKit, and then the user can place them in the control center and on the lock screen. Let's have a look at how this implementation is done and be surprised by how easy and straightforward it actually is. So in my example here, this is my intermittent fasting app. It's nothing too special, it just tracks your fasting duration. And when we press this play button here, then I will start fasting. As you can see, now the timer started in the app. And then when I hit the pause button, you will say the timer reset, and I have now stopped fasting. This is actually super simple. Let me walk you through what's needed. So first of all, in your widgets bundle or your widget bundle definition, which means that you will have to have a widget extension. I am now assuming that you already know how WidgetKit works. If you don't know, click the video that's linked up there where I have an entire masterclass on WidgetKit, and you can learn everything that you need to know in order to move along with this video. But if you do already know about WidgetKit, then you know that we have a widget bundle where we have multiple widgets. In this example, iFWidgets is just a regular home screen widget that I support in this app. And then iFControlWidget is the new one that we are creating for this control center support. There is a new protocol that we need to conform to, and it's called ControlWidget. This is part of WidgetKit, and it is only available in iOS 18.0 and up. The control widget is very similar to other widgets where it has a kind, and there's a typo in here as this is just an example. I will probably revamp this at a later point in time, so don't worry about this typo here. It has a kind, which is basically the identifier for this widget. You can use that identifier if you want to reload the widget, for example. And then it has a body, which is some control widget configuration. In here, creating this simple static control widget is super easy by just creating a static control configuration with the kind identifier that we created above. Of course, you could do this in line as well. And then in here, I'm just adding a control widget button. The interesting thing about the control widget button is that this means that there is no timeline, there is no timeline entry, and there is also no dedicated view, as you probably know from WidgetKit and all of the other places where widgets are used. Instead, there is this control widget button that is based on an app intent. I have told you for quite a few months now that app intents is probably getting more important throughout the iOS ecosystem, and here is once again another place where we need to know about the app intents framework. If you don't know about that yet, make sure you click that link up there or in the video description. I have an entire playlist on app intents and how you can use it in your apps and how they are built. So basically this button, when you press the button, it just toggles or performs the intent that you specify in here, and then inside of this closer you just have the view that gets displayed in the button. So in this example, it's just a label using either the pause or play as a symbol with some text here that's dependent on some user defaults value that I'm sharing between this widget extension and the main app. But that's an implementation detail, it doesn't matter to you. What you need to know is protocol is called control widget, has a control widget configuration, which is static control configuration. And there you have a control widget button with an action that is based on an intent.